Hey, this is Adam Post, publisher of College of the Dead, 30-year veteran of making comic books, and, well, thank goodness, you know, we just found out recently, this is just dated from yesterday, September 12th, 2019, X-Men and Wolverine may be race-bent by Marvel and Kevin Feige. He's their head producer over at Marvel, and the good thing about this is they can mix up all the races together, and they don't even have to make a good story. They don't have to make, like, good special effects. Nothing important has to happen in the story. Doesn't even have to be well done. They just mix up the races, and then they make a lot of money. You just mix up the races. So it says here in Marvel's Phase 4 plans that now Kevin Feige may change the race behind the X-Men characters, but, of course, even possibly Wolverine, and also... Victoria Alonso also said that the X-Men, just the title, the X-Men, because it has the word men in it, if it said X-Women, that'd be okay, but it says X-Men, so it's outdated because it has the word men in it. But I think they still have men in the world. There's only one of me, but it's not outdated. It's always been that way. I've always been one person. What we're looking at here is the incredible, unbelievable, world-changing success of Captain Marvel, which somehow they managed to report $1 billion in box office. They figured out that diversity would be the future of Marvel and the MCU, the Marvel Comics universe. And I don't know. I mean, this article in Cosmic Book News, which has been a pretty good website, has a pretty even-handed take on all this stuff. And, they changed the race in The Little Mermaid. That actually looked fine. It was cool. It's hardly like, why even make it news? But then again, like, you're changing up the races of all the characters. I guess they'll change up the genders next of all the characters. They're already working on that for Thor. And I don't know how that accomplishes making it a good story. You know, that's the thing that you look at this and you say, hey, well, you know, if you've been interested in Wolverine since the 1980s, like I have, you would say, like, well, just, you know, do a good Wolverine. Fox did a good Wolverine. He was pretty cool. It was pretty true to what you would think Wolverine would be. And again, it doesn't matter if you want to have a character of one race or a gender of another race or an age of another race or change the character's abilities. You can do whatever you want. You have superheroes in fantasy. Make it whatever you want to make it. It's just when you take something that people are used to and then you change it up a bunch of different ways to try to include other elements that never existed. Like, why not just make him a robot, you know, right? Or make him an inanimate object and just call that inanimate object, like Wolverine. They do it in such a way where you don't even get a sense that they are going to creators and asking creators what they think. They don't seem to care what creators think. They just make whatever they want. But that is the future. And if you're going to sell your properties to major companies and your characters and your stories to major companies, they will do whatever they think is good to do with them. And that's their choice to do it. So this is why a bunch of other comic book creators like myself have gone and started publishing our own comics. And I have this series, College of the Dead. And I will show you all about it. In a video that's just about to start now at the end of this video. If you like this video, if you're happy to find out about the X-Men and Wolverine changing up their races and genders and the things they're all about and what they believe in and all sorts of crazy things, go ahead and make sure to subscribe to this channel, like this video, and share this video.
Hey, how you doing? College of the Dead is my 140-page zombie apocalypse comic book. It's black and white. It's completely done. The first printing ships October 31st, 2019. Make sure you get a chance to get a copy of this. It's on Indiegogo. It was successfully fully funded. All the money was raised for it. It's going to be shipping in October, and that will be the first printing. We'll have a few copies of that beyond what people pre-ordered, but not a heck of a lot. So go ahead and make sure you get a copy of this. And you can see the link in the description below. You can also go to collegeofthedead.com. It will take you to where it's currently available. And I'll tell you what, this is a phenomenal comic book. You can see the cover of book two right here. We're working on that right now to finish it for January 2020. And these are the interiors of College of the Dead book one, all done by the same artist, Javier Aranda. He's a phenomenal artist. And go ahead and check this out. I know you're going to love this comic book.